Now some music. Tiernan Og made three studio albums between 1971 and 1973. And now, 40 years later, could it be? Could it be 40 years later? The two friends, Sonny Condell and Leo O'Kelly, are still gigging and still making music together. We'll talk to them in a few minutes' time. But we're going to hear first one of their songs. This is called Dante. Three, four.
Somewhere it lay across the land. Soil was fine and warm in the hand. The shepherdess and the sheepdog, they kept a loving view on starry nights that lambs might stray from the ewe. And the summer came from somewhere. Now her journey's done. Dante loves the summer sun. White clover and mountains, a sight to fill. Yet eyes have seen and still wonder why. Dante turns for home again, her rosy cheeks at evensong, but she won't leave her flock.
Wonderful live sound from Tiernan Og, Leo Kelly and Sonny Condell and Dante. And we'll have a chat about their reunification in a few minutes and where you can hear them gigging. But first we're going to talk about something entirely different. Some good wishes for Sonny and Leo from Nuala Swamp. If they remember who Nuala at the Swamp is, happy memories.
Oh, yeah.
Sonny's a regular performer at the Phoenix Folk Club in Ballyfermot. Please mention that he's a wonderful painter. Michael Coakley, the organiser of that. Would love to see Tiernan Og in DeBarra's again. Have a CD by them of a John Peel session. All fantastic. Last night we had Glenn Hansard in DeBarra's and it was absolutely amazing, says Jens in Clonakilty. So lots of people out there, Leo and Sonny, are anxious to hear more of your music.
That sounds good.
Let's go back to the very beginning.
Thank you.
Because you were literally an overnight success in commercial terms. How did you meet?
I think we met in Carlow the first time. Sonny and his cousin John were playing in our local ballad lounge called Carpenter's. And I just happened to see them and I thought they were fantastic. I borrowed Sonny's guitar during the break and sang a song myself.
And was that a meeting of minds and music instantaneously?
Well, it was sometime later then we met up in Dublin and started going to the folk clubs in Dublin and started to work together after that. Then.
Mm. Now, tell me about how you got your record deal, because it's the stuff of dreams.
I think so. Well, we took the boat over to England. We went to a party at some friends we'd never met before that evening, Met a sound engineer there, said, "What you doing over here, guys?" We said, he said, "Look, I work in a recording studio. I'll bring you in after hours, make your demo," which we brought the next week to Chrysalis Records and got signed up.
Immediately.
Yeah.
And the success wasn't, it wasn't a temporary success. You had three albums and great commercial success up and down England. I mean, you've gigged in all the folk clubs. You were massive.
We did a huge amount of gigging, actually, around England and across Europe as well. So, yeah, we were working very hard.
Now, there was, if you like, a scene at the time, wasn't there, for your kind of music, acoustic, folk-based music?
Yeah, there was, although we found ourselves a lot of the time with heavy rock bands for some reason or other. Oh, yeah. And so, yeah, it was a mixture. And we did a lot of folk clubs as well in our own right as well. So. Mm. Yeah.
Now, three albums, three great successes, and then what happened?
Well, we sort of felt we were worked out, really. We needed to take a break, and so we did.
how long was the break?
A couple of years, I guess.
Yeah,
we gradually got back to working with each other again.
All right, and the latest, I know you were in with us recently playing with Scullion.
Yeah.
So you're doing that as well.
I am, yeah.
And Leo, I presume you're doing solo work.
Certainly. I've got a solo album called Will. It's coming out in February. That'll be available on leoo'kelly.ie, as is the Tiernan and Oge live album that we recorded in Cove live at Sirius. That's just been out a few months. So that's and people can get it there if they like.
Okay, what's it like playing together again after all these years?
It's strange. We seem to slot in to a kind of groove together, I think.
Yeah, I think so. It's funny. It's always like we've never been apart, really.
Yeah.
The funny thing is we don't, I think our last rehearsal was probably 1970.
You don't have to do rehearsal, it's just, there's kind of, what do they call it, muscle memory?
I suppose in guitar terms,
finger memory, yeah. It just goes to where it has to go.
It is really like that, your fingers, without thinking about it, it is like that, yeah.
How are you going down with the contemporary audience? I mean, not everyone is your own age, shall we say, in your audience. It's probably quite the contrary.
I think we're going down better than ever, actually. And particularly in Britain now, we did some gigs during the summer, some festivals, and London. We're doing the London Borderline soon, too. And from older people who remember us from then and people who've never heard us before. And, for instance, we played a festival in Wales called Sonic Rock Festival, and that was completely rock except for us. And apparently we were the only band of the weekend who got an encore, and people really did respond in a fantastic way to it.
Yeah, I mean, we live in the so-called X Factor generation, Sonny. I mean, it's very different to the way, I mean, you were an overnight success, but you had all the equipment that was needed in terms of your own musical abilities and a repertoire. It's very different today, the people who are overnight successes.
Yeah, I suppose they seem to use a lot of older songs, which I think is kind of strange.
But it tells us something, doesn't it?
Yeah,
that what resonates are the songs, the classic songs,
yeah,
over the years. I want to leave time for another song. What would you like to do for us?
Well, this is probably the oldest one we did. I wrote this in 1968 in Carlo, and it's called Looking Up. This is from the first album, too.
Okay.
Along, I you're like the white daisies that spring beneath your feet. When you start to speak, I gather all your precious loving words to say for when I'm old. When you go to sleep, seven good fairies come and sprinkle you with love. When you start to wake, three elfin painters with their jars of sunbeam color your window.
Terrific. Absolutely great. Sonny Condell and Leo Kelly as Tiernan Oak. Thank you very much for joining us. Now, the gigs that you're doing, the ones I have here, February the 5th, the Island Arts Centre in Lisburn, February the 18th, the Sirius Arts Centre, February the 19th, Wexford Arts Centre, and on March 19th in Blanchardstown, April the 12th in Whelans in Dublin. But I suspect those gaps in the diary might well be filled up in between.
I think there will be, and we're contactable on Facebook and MySpace and
or as Tiernan Og, and collectively and individually, I'm sure.
Collectively and individually, probably individually easier. Otherwise, we're in the phone book.
All right. Leo and Sonny, thank you very much. Thanks to Leo, we had a great barbecue in Oak Park one frosty Halloween about 1962. That's from a man called Hugh O'Rourke, who says we were past pupils. We are past pupils of CBS. And lots of good comment coming in for Tiernan Og. And that's all we have time for. Don't forget, the Frontline returns tonight at 10:35. We'll be firing the first salvos.